Hi, this is Lisa Hayden and you are watching BollywoodHangama.com.
What older men and younger women have in common is that they are both suffering from different insecurities. She is looking for someone to make her feel safe and he is looking for someone who doesn't answer back and is a trophy. That's what Mark Barrowcliffe has said. And we have this Lisa Hayden. She's playing the fantasy of three experienced men in The Shockeens. Huge pleasure to have you back on Border Hangama, first of all.
Thank you.
Mr. Anupur is sitting over
me.
Here, so I'll say experience is a better word, actually.
He doesn't mind. He calls himself a lech in the movie. He looks over at me in interviews and he's like, do you mind if I call us leches?
Right.
I'm like, no, please go for it.
Great. So what do you have to say about this entire analogy?
I think women are more looking for, I mean, not necessarily someone to feed their insecurities, but maybe someone to give them validation or respect or just, I think it's the same for men and women in a sense. You just want to kind of have someone that you can count on or that you can rely on that sort of appreciates you and takes you in all your different ways and forms and with all your spastic, weird screaming and, you know, good moods, bad moods.
Let's get into like a fun and in a way a frivolous mood if possible.
Okay.
Because I think that's what the movie is all about. It's like light-hearted. Do you feel that I think it happens all the time that older men they just lech on younger women.
I told someone this morning, I'm like, you know what, if it happens, I'm not noticing. And I think like that's what me and Ahana have in common. I'm sure, I think men just appreciate women's beauty. I think even women appreciate women's beauty. I mean, I like looking at beautiful women too, but I'm not necessarily a lech. But I do know that this subject matter is obviously something that
contentious.
It's very touchy in our country.
Right.
But I mean, I'm not an old man, so I can't say, but I do
know. You're saying that you like women, attractive women?
I like to look at attractive women.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, like, I would rather look at a women's magazine and see beautiful women in a... Women's magazines have beautiful women in them. You don't have beautiful men in women's magazines. Even in men's magazines, you have beautiful women. So, like, beautiful women are something beautiful to look at. There's something nice about a beautiful woman.
Do you feel that sex is overhyped in this country and over just spoken about because people just keep a lot undercover?
I think that we do pay too much attention to it in a way that is not necessarily natural.
Right.
I think if we treated it more blasé and we were more open about it and we were less scandalous or gossipy or enthralled by it, that it would be less of an issue, perhaps. I think a lot of it also stems from the fact that we don't talk about it. It's taboo to talk about, sure.
Right.
Sure. I mean, a lot of people don't really like to talk about dating or, you know, anything that happens before marriage. I think a lot of it also has to do with the way that we are raised. I know that people that grow up near the ocean are very sporting, or dancers, for example. I know so many dancers in this country that feel so uninhibited about their bodies because they spend their whole life expressing themselves through body movement. And I think that's something that's really important to do, is to realize that your body is a natural thing. It's not a sinful thing. It's not a vulgar thing. It's not even a sensual thing. It's just, it's your body.
It's generally said that women are very instinctive. They can get the vibes as how someone is looking at them. What do you think is the difference of hardcore leching and innocuous flirting as such? Do you find the difference, and which is the one that you think can be attractive?
I think leching more has to do with sort of craving in a vulgar fashion, or not seeing things for what they really are. And in that sense, I wouldn't say that the three gentlemen in Shawkeens are leches, because they have their reasons. It's coming out via comedy. You know, Kher Sab's wife hasn't touched him in 30 years. Piyush Ji's wife died many years ago and he's never had the courage to approach anyone else. So in that sense, it's coming from a very sort of funny, innocent, sweet space.
Yeah.
But leching, I feel, is... again, like I said, it's sort of wanting something for vulgar reasons,
right.
Whereas...
But you know, why are you saying it's vulgar? Because even an older man, they have the similar sentiments. The body, if it is with them, they still have everything running for them.
I think anything that doesn't come from inside of you, anything that doesn't come from an authentic space, or that is, becomes cheap. I'm really scared to talk about all of this on your channel right now, because...
No.
Okay, for example, even when it comes to dating or someone flirting with you, if it's coming from a very sort of quick, unclassy place, then it starts to feel cheap, and I don't like anything to feel cheap. So I think if it comes from a place that's a little more interesting, or something more than just a fixation with the way the physical form is, then that becomes more tolerable or respectful.
When it comes to the Shaukeens, which of the three men, if you have to look at it in hindsight, you felt that they approached you in a way which was classy, and you felt that it was really sweet?
According to Ahana, all three of them, they're like her father, you know? She sees these three father figures have wandered into her house, and they're, you know, all doing things for her and taking her places and and helping her in her life and paying attention to her. And Ahana is very attention deficient. She likes to have a lot of attention. So I think that she loves all three of them in a different way.
Okay, but she also says that if someone can help her meet Akshay Kumar, so she
who does she have to sleep with to meet Akshay Kumar?
Yeah, that is a statement, and in a way, three frustrated men, experienced men, it has I think a ricocheting effect on them in a way as well.
It does have a ricocheting effect, and how you have to watch the movie to see. But for Ahana, that's just the way she speaks. You know what I'm saying? It's a throwaway line. She doesn't mean it. It's a figure of speech. She's probably said it 300 times before to her girlfriends, to anyone. And but to these three men, they've never heard anyone talk like this. Who do they have to sleep with? You know? So it does have a ricocheting effect in their minds.
This is just a conversation that we're having. I just want to take your opinion. There's a perception. Many men at times feel that women can be coquettish. They say that
I didn't mean
coquettish in the sense that the way you said that she said that she can sleep and all that stuff. But then later they said that I didn't mean it that ways. Somewhere. So men, in the sense, their line of thinking is pretty straightforward, and women have a bit of a spiraling and a, you know, zigzag way of.
Women are more complex.
Do you agree with that? You know, in a way, they're more complex. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, women they
just lead the men on, and then they say that I didn't mean it like that.
I don't think it's about leading men on. I think it's more about, I don't know. Women are very testy kinds of people. You know,
they like testing.
Yeah, they're very testy. They'll see what they can get. They'll approach things from different angles. They try and be intelligent about stuff. I think at the end of the day, a really intelligent woman just also starts to become straightforward, realizing that men are so basic. They're so easy to navigate if you actually think about it.
Men are very, very, very predictable.
Yeah, there's books and books and books written on this men-woman thing, but like really it's...
Men are very predictable.
Very.
And women are not.
Women aren't, they're smart, they think too much.
Right, they think too much. What do you think is a woman really wants? What do you think is a woman is really looking for in a man, like an older man or younger man or any sort of man? What do you think she's looking
for? I can't really speak on behalf of women. I think in a very I meet you kind of way, first you want chemistry. You know what I'm saying? You want someone to kind of pay attention, have some witty banter going, someone that gets your jokes, someone with a connection, I guess, chemistry. And then after that, I think it's just a best friend, to be honest with you. A best friend that you kind of like to do everything with.
Okay.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. I mean, it's such a complex question. It depends on the time of day. I need something different every time of day.
Absolutely. A best friend and then...
Okay. A best friend and everything else.
Everything else.
Everything else. Fill a jogging buddy, a yoga buddy, someone to cook dinner with me, someone to drink. I don't know, everything.
Right. But men are looking for something else as well. Don't you think? Women have these
You're
things.
You're trying to get this word out of my mouth.
I'm just curious. We're having a conversation. Nothing.
Yeah, just on television.
Just on television.
Yeah.
All right. So, Akshay Kumar, you have this fascination for Akshay Kumar as well, and I believe how does it feel that you're working with Akshay Kumar, and he's a very good looking man and a very fine actor as well.
He is a very fine actor. The thing that I find finest about him was the sort of non-intimidating character that he brings. Obviously he is who he is, and he's Akshay Kumar, and he's got a huge body of work behind him, and there's a lot of respect that comes for a person like that. But when you're acting with him, you don't feel like he carries that baggage around, and I think that's the thing that I love most about being his co-actor.
Great. Manali Trans, I think, is a song that Yo-Yo Honey Singh has composed.
It's a track that's got sort of a dubstep, well, it's got dubstep in it, and it's got, I wouldn't say it's got trance in it per se, it's sort of got a very, I wish Yo-Yo was here to describe it for you, it's got a swing sort of rhythmic guitar something happening in the back, or a tune, it's got a catchy tune, that's what it is. And it's got dubstep rolled in, and then it's got Yo-Yo rapping at the same time, and there's also a girl in there that sings as well. It's good. It's a really, like, the first time I heard the track, I thought, I like this track.
How does it feel that you got a fabulous response for Queen? Were you anticipating it by any chance? A small role, but people loved it like anything.
I didn't anticipate it at all. I really didn't anticipate it. I met you before the film came
out.
Exactly,
right.
It feels amazing. It feels really, really good, and I'm glad that I think the part that's most special is that it was a small role, but that character had so much sort of power inside of her, or, you know, the power to make people feel something, or just to fall in love with her. That was the nicest part.
You think it was a naturalness of the performance that really worked in your advantage?
I think so. I think Vikas Bell really brought that out in all of the characters in the film. I think he insisted that it be a really authentic performance and very true to life. And right. There was a lot of improvisation action. We were on set, and that was very nerve-wracking at times, not knowing what was going on in a scene, but just having to be present. And also not being that experienced an actor. But I think that in the end, and those were all the reasons why I didn't expect anything, because I didn't feel good when I shot Queen, in the sense that I didn't know how the scene had come out, because it wasn't planned. Does that make sense? So you're kind of taking a shot in the dark. It's like stringing a bass in the dark, and you don't really know how everything's going to come together until you watch the movie.
Sure,
and then
sure.
when it works that way, it was like, oh, okay, so that's what he was doing. You know, so it all kind of made sense when I watched the film.
A lot of your fans would like to know, especially after what you managed to do in Queen, and you're looking good in the Shawkeens. What are you doing next? Because people would want to see much more of Lisa Hayden now as an actress as well.
Hopefully. I'm deciding what to do next. There's a few different things on the table. So we're going to definitely pick and choose in the next couple of weeks, and we'll know then.
Lisa, thank you very much for being on Bordering-ama. Lovely to
thank
have you back. And all the best wishes for the Shawkeens. I hope that you have a good time.
Thank you.
Promoting it as well. I hope that you enjoy the entire promotions part as well. And hopefully the performance lives up to the expectations.
I hope
performance lives up to the expectations.
I hope so too. I've got big shoes to fill now. Oh, that Biju Lakshmi.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank
all the best.
You.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
That's all from Bordering-ama. Keep on watching. Hi, this is Faridoon Shahryar. For the most interesting celebrity interviews, do subscribe to Bordering-ama. Keep on watching. I'm